Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this infographic in Word and save it as an image. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to Insert, Shapes, go to the drop down, and I'm going to go to this curved, edged or rounded rectangle. Click on it, and then just click and drag out a rectangle. There we go. Now, when you insert a shape in Word, it'll have a border line and a fill color. So at the moment, if you select it, you'll have this shape format tab at the top here. Click on that. I'm going to go to shape outline, click on the drop down and select no outline. And then I'm just going to duplicate this shape before we make it white. So I'm just going to select it. Now, for me, I'm going to hit the Alt key on my keyboard. You see my cursor's changed. I'm going to click and drag out another one, but you can use Command or Control C followed by Command or Control V, or you can simply select it, go to the Home tab, press Copy, deselect it, and then just press Paste. Now for this rectangle, I'm going to reduce the size of it by just clicking on the little square and moving that over. And I'm going to change the color of this shape and then put it on the top of this one. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Fill, click on the drop down. You can select from a number of colors here. You can alternatively go to More Fill Colors and you'll be given the color wheel. Move this little cursor around the color wheel to select a different color. Your color will appear in this square here. And you can also use the slider to make that color brighter or darker. So in my colors here, I've got some recent colors that I've selected. So I'm going to choose this orange, and I'm just going to place it over the top of this shape here. Then I'm going to select the larger shape, go to Shape Fill and select white. And then when I've selected this shape and I've gone to the Shape Format tab, I'm going to go all the way over to Format Pane and click here. And you'll see this menu, Fill and Line. Fill again is the middle color. Click on the drop down and you can see I've got solid fill and mine is white, and also the line which we've taken out, so we've got no line. So in this menu, I'm going to go to the effects here and go to shadow. And then I'm going to go to this preset here and select a shadow of my choice. I'm going to go to the middle one. It's the one right of that, so you can't see it. And you can see that shadow at the bottom there. Then we're going to go and insert a triangle. So insert, shapes, and down to the triangle. Click and drag out a triangle. Then we're going to rotate it. Just go to this circular arrow here, rotate it all the way around. And then I'm going to pop it on the end here. Again, I'm going to take out the line, come over to the menu here, no line. And then on solid fill, I'm going to select color and then white. And then again, go to effects, shadow, and select the same shadow. Click away. You can see I've got a little line here. So I'm just going to move that up with my arrow key. Click away, and that's gone. Perfect. Now, don't worry about the fact that you can't see the line at the top here. We're going to change the background so it'll become more prominent. So now we're just going to select an icon to go at the end here. Go to Insert, Icon, and over on the right here, you can just type in anything you want related to your subject matter. So I'm just going to type in Research, and I'm going to select this icon here. There's lots to choose from. Click Insert, and as you can see, my icon has appeared behind all of my other shapes. So select it, right-click, go down to Wrap Text and select In Front of Text. And whilst we're here and it's selected, go to Graphics Format. Go to Graphics Fill, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select the orange color. And then I'm just going to move that to the end, reduce it down, and I'm going to align everything right at the end. So we're going to infill now with some text. So go to Insert. And I'm going to choose Word Art because unfortunately you cannot save text from a text box. So if you wanted to save this as an image or a picture. You can't if you use text boxes, but you can if you use word art. So let's go to word art and let's just pull this over here. And then we're just going to just change that text to 01. And then I'm just going to move that to the middle a little bit, go to the home tab, and I'm going to increase the size of that text, but I'm going to use this icon here, increase font size. That's about right. I'm going to go to this icon and change the color of my font to white. I'm also going to change the font to Arial. And you can just about see there's a little shadow on these numbers. Now you can keep them if you want to. I'm going to get rid of them. So select the text, go back over to Format Shape, go to Text Options, go to this icon here, then go to Shadow, click on the drop down and select No Shadow. And there you can see it's gone. Again, I'm going to go to Insert, Word Art, do exactly the same thing again. This time I'm just going to insert some text here. I'm just going to reduce the size of this text, select it, go to the Home tab, and I'm going to use the Decrease Font Size tool. Then I'm going to go over here to make sure that my text is aligned to the left. Then I'm just going to add some more text below. I'm just going to paste this in. I don't think you want to watch me typing. And then click away, see if you're generally happy with that. And then we can align everything and then we can simply copy it and then readjust each of those copies. So I'm going to make sure the one is in the middle of this box. So select the one, hold your command key down on your keyboard and select the orange square or rectangle. Go to Shape Format, go to Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle, and that number now will be perfectly lined up in the center of that square. Now with the text, sometimes you have to do this by eye because it'll sometimes align, but if the margins are slightly out, it won't quite align to the middle. So you may have to come back and align that at the end. So because we can't quite see the top of this rectangle here, let's just change the shape color. There we go. That looks pretty much lined up. I'm just gonna knock that down one more. And I'm just going to move it over to the right. Now this icon here, I want to place in the middle between the top and bottom here. So I've selected it, hold the Command or Control key down, select the large rectangle, go to Align and then Align to Middle. And you can see they're perfectly lined up. So let's just change the color of the arrow. So I was going to keep the background white, but actually I think it looks a lot better grey because then you can keep the white background nice and clean and you can place it on any document you want. Once you're happy with the layout, select each element by holding down your Command or Control key. Keep selecting everything. Make sure you've got the background, the text boxes, and the shapes. Select it all. Go to Group and select Group. Now this is one group that you can move around as one element. It also makes copy and pasting much easier. You don't have to go through and copy and paste everything. So I'm going to hold down my Alt key, click and drag, and I'm just going to click and drag out one more time. Perfect. Now I'm just going to align all of these to my page. So select all of the groups, holding down the Command or Control key. Go to Align. I'm going to distribute vertically, which means there'll be the same gaps between each one. And then we're also going to align to the left, make sure they're all perfectly lined up. And then just very quickly going to group them all. And then I'm going to align it to my page. So align to the center of my page, align to the middle of my page. And if I click off, those are all perfectly lined up on my page. Now, you're obviously going to want to change each of these elements. So again, select the whole of the infographic, go to Group and select Ungroup. Go to this one here and select Ungroup. And again with this one, Ungroup. And again with the final one. Now, let's change the background colors of these shapes. So select it, make sure you're on shape format, shape fill, and let's change the color here. And this one. And this one here. Perfect. Again, if you want to change the icons, let's just delete these icons. Let's insert icon. Let's select this one, insert. Again, when it's inserted, it may disappear somewhere. Just right-click on it, wrap text in front of text. Alternatively, if you can't, just select it, go to graphics format, wrap text is here, click on the drop-down, and again, in front of text. And then again, we can go to the graphics fill here and change the color. We want this one to be pink. So let's move that one down and reduce the size of it. You can turn this one round if you want to, but you will have to align it yourself in terms of where it lines top and bottom. Perfect. Now, once you've completed this, if you want to use this infographic as an image, we need to go ahead and we need to group everything together again. So I'm going to group everything individually again, like this, go to group and then group. Rather than group the whole thing in bits together, I'm just going to group the individual ones, and it makes it easier then to come back and edit. Now I've grouped the individual element, I'm now going to group all of them together. Group, and now it's one group. If you right click, go down to save as picture, I'm going to save to my desktop. Let's put picture one, let's keep it as that, but you must save it as a PNG. So you have these save as type of files, you must save it as a PNG, and that way the background will be completely transparent. So if you then put this picture onto a different colored background, you will just get the elements that you've made and not a white background. Click save, and then if I open a new document and I go to insert, picture, picture from file, and then you see picture one, click insert, and you can see now this is a picture, you can't move it around, so again right click, wrap text in front of text, and now you can move this anywhere in your document, but you can also resize it beautifully without it distorting. So you can put that into your websites, on social media, or into PowerPoint presentations. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.